So I don't like getting these videos out so close to the next game. I'm talking about my game recaps that I do. I would prefer to get them out the day after, which is why at first I was calling them day after recaps, but I have a couple issues when it comes to getting these videos out. First off, lately, it's been hard for me to record. A lot of times I have to record in my truck, but if I forget to leave my laptop plugged in before I leave to go record in my truck, then my laptop will be dead, and it just causes a lot of problems with that. But also, I don't really know how to attack each game recap. Do you guys want me to recap the game, you know, a little 1 to 2 minute recap talking about some key plays? Or do you guys just want me to go straight into stats? Because you have the full highlights, the 9, almost 10 minute full highlight clips that Eric puts together, and you guys could watch that and then come watch the game recaps. That's what I would recommend. So given that we provide full highlights, do you just not even want me to recap the actual game since you guys can watch those? I don't know. Basically, I've struggled with how to attack each game recap. I don't really have a set structure, and that makes it harder to kind of go in and easily record a video. A lot of game recaps, I'll try and do too much, and I'll record for 20 minutes, and then cutting that down to 10 minutes or so is very, very tough. We have to keep it under 9:45 because of NBA rules. They will block your video if it's over 9:45. So basically, game recaps have been the hardest video for me to make. So I want you guys to give me some advice down in the comment section below. Let me know exactly what you want to see in each game recap. It might be different for a win and for a loss. If there is a difference in what you want to see based on whether we win or lose, let me know that as well. Whether it's a short recap highlighting top plays, combined with looking all the way down the box score and listing off player and team stats and focusing a lot of time on that. Do you want me to recap? Do you want me to come up with more takeaways from each game and elaborate more on those? Do you want me to spend more time previewing the next game? I want to give you guys something that you guys like to watch, and I also want to be able to go into a recording session and know exactly what I'm going to do and basically have a template that I can go by and basically have a structure that I'm used to so that it's easier to record, because a lot of times I struggle with that. As you can see, I am prone to over talking, as this intro is almost 3 minutes long, but getting a little bit of advice from you guys would actually help me get this video out a little bit faster, since I will actually know what I'm doing. So let's jump into a short little game recap for the Milwaukee Bucks versus Portland Trail Blazers. The Trail Blazers ran away with this game, winning 118 to 103 in what was their best win of the season. This game was CJ's coming out party, or maybe his comeback party, because he was struggling throughout the first 10 games of the season, and I said so in my last video that he just needs to get comfortable without ISOing as much and playing more in the flow of the offense. And I know he's looking to make the right pass, and he's been making the right pass more, even though it hasn't resulted in more assists, but he needs to find that balance and that comfort level with being a team player, but still staying aggressive and looking for his own shot. Well, it all culminated with a 40-point game last night against a very solid Milwaukee Bucks defense. CJ was 17 for 26 from the field, 5 for 10 from the three-point line, and with those 40 points, he also had 6 assists, which is really impressive, and that shows that he found that balance in that Milwaukee Buck game between being an efficient volume scorer, dropping 40 points, and making the right passes and getting 6 assists. This was possibly CJ's best game of his career. I know he had that 50-point outing against the Chicago Bulls last year where he went off in the first 3 quarters, but he was making the right passes too, which is a big part of his progression in the future that will help him become a better player. Outside of CJ, Evan Turner had a very solid game off the bench. He had 16 points, 11 rebounds, and 4 assists. Damian Lillard started hot. He hit a couple threes to get going, but he only finished with 13 points, 6 rebounds, and 3 assists on 5 for 15 shooting. And the thing I noticed with Dame, He was looking to set up CJ, and that's what I love about Dame. He's an unselfish superstar who, if his teammates are going, he'll look to get them the ball and keep their hot streak rolling, and that's for the betterment of the team. Dame could easily go out and chase a 30-point-per-game scoring average, but he doesn't do that. He's not concerned about his numbers, he's concerned about the team winning. And feeding CJ McCollum was what was helping the team win. Jake Layman had a 10-point effort in only 15 minutes. He was 4-for-9 from the field, 2-for-6 from the three-point line. And like I said in my last video, he needs to see more playing time because he's been very solid to start this season. Al-Farouq Aminu, 3-for-5 from the field, 2-for-4 from three, 8 points, 7 rebounds. He played solid defense. This is the type of Al-Farouq Aminu that we need to see for the rest of the season. Giannis Antetokounmpo was held below his scoring average. Evan Turner did a decent job against him, especially since Evan Turner is giving up like 4 inches in height and a lot in the length department. And Giannis had like 9 dunks, but he was held below his scoring average. 23 points from Giannis, you'll live with that. Brooke Lopez hit 6 threes and scored 22 points, and he was absolutely killing us from the perimeter. Chris Middleton had 22 points as well. He hit 4 threes. But outside of that, nobody had over 10 points. And it really was not an impressive effort from the Milwaukee Bucks in terms of the offensive department. And that's due to the Portland Trail Blazers playing better defense, which is my number one takeaway. While the scores are higher, it doesn't mean that our defense is worse. After this game, we're actually the 4th best defense in terms of defensive efficiency in the entire league. The Minnesota Timberwolves game helped us out in that department because we absolutely locked them down and they were without many key players, but still, it's some progression from last year. Last year, we were like the 8th best defense. So the fact that we've gotten even better on defense and we've gotten our offense back up to levels it was before last season, right now, we're the 2nd best offense in the league. So it's a very promising early season stretch for the Portland Trail Blazers. And if we can get CJ playing like he did against the Milwaukee Bucks for the rest of the season, obviously he's not going to be putting up 40 points per game on that type of efficiency, but if we can get him back to where he was a couple years ago in terms of the efficiency department, then we're going to be very, very dangerous because this team already looks great, and that's with CJ struggling throughout the season. And that's without Maurice Harkless, who knows what's up with him. He might be out for the season. I have no idea. But CJ playing like this, our defense playing like this, our bench playing like this, Damian Lillard looks to have taken the next step. I could have not asked for a better start to the season. We're known for starting slow. But right now, we're playing great basketball, and if we can combine a hot first half of the season with our typical late season surge that we have almost every single season, who knows how many games we could win? Who knows? We might be able to get that second seed because the Houston Rockets don't look too good, and nobody really stands out except for the Golden State Warriors. The Denver Nuggets haven't had a tough schedule so far. I know they're playing really good, but that's a team that I think that we can compete against. I want to get that 2 seed. That'd be pretty awesome. Maybe I'm getting ahead of myself. Maybe I'm getting too excited with this early season start, but it's as promising as it could possibly be. So we're going against the Los Angeles Clippers tonight. That game might have already started by the time this is uploaded, so it's really late upload. I apologize for that, like I said at the start. Let me know down in the comments section below what you want to see out of game recap so I can kind of record these and edit these more efficiently. They're missing a ton of solid players. Tobias Harris might be out. Avery Bradley's out. I forget who else is out. There's somebody else that's a solid player that's out for them as well. We got to take care of business. Losing against the Clippers would be a huge letdown and kind of kill our early season momentum. It'd be nice to go 9-3 going into the Boston Celtics matchup on Sunday. And anyway, True Blazer fans, that's all I got for this game recap. I hope you guys enjoy this Clippers game. So peace out. Go Blazers.